good thing happened, beating Notre Dame, but excited to be here, but are looking forward to the challenge. I understand I played for the Hornets. I've lived in Charlotte for 3 years in the mid-90s, so I know that this is certainly a pro-Carolina crowd, and we're playing the number one seed. It's a great challenge for our system.
I don't think Tony slows the ball down right now. I think they try to be very efficient. They don't take bad shots. They don't make stupid passes. They don't beat themselves.
So, that's a good defense. They help out a lot. They have great athletes, so, their defense is real good. I think if we just run or just keep it to our game plan, we'll be able to run against them and things like that as long as we stop them from scoring.
No, they're a good enough team as it is if you slow them down. So the ability to get back and limit their great shots and make each shot, a tough contested one, and, hopefully that'll frustrate them all night.
I think if you're going to have a chance against North Carolina, you have to try and take care of the basketball, because when they turn you over, they're at the other end laying it in before you can even get close to getting back.
You know, we've been in tough battles before. We've been in tough games, and we've proven that we're definitely tough enough to win lowest scoring games where, we got to battle out to the last possession on defense.
We'll still have to play when opportunities are there. You have to take advantage of them. And we talk about being patient, sound, and aggressive. That's the key.
I like to win in the 80s, 90s, but to be the team that we reach the dreams that we have, be the team we want to be, you got to be able to win at somebody else's a different tempo. It can't be your own comfort zone all the time.
Tyler Hasbro is a great player. He's National Player of the Year in college basketball, so it's going to be a tough one. But, he throws his body around a lot down there, kind of like a thrashing croc in the paint down there. So should be a nice little challenge, but just gotta get down there and try and make him play over some big bodies that we can throw at him, and just hopefully do our best that way. So
he's so obviously explosive and strong, and obviously he's a winner. That's first and foremost. Does he make his team win? And he looks like he's complete, but boy, when he gets ahead of steam and gets going, very difficult to stop.
Their kids don't try to do things they can't do. Rochester, just a phenomenal kid, makes great decisions, great assist-to-error ratio, a lot better athlete than people think he is. Derek Lowe is a fantastic shooter who can also put the ball on the floor, who's really crafty, starts around behind the screen and then cuts back door, and all of a sudden he's got a layup. Weaver, who's just a big-time athlete who can put the ball on the floor, who can shoot the three-point shot, who can post you up, who has a wonderful assist-error ratio. And then they got some big guys who, shoot 56% and 59%, I think, are the two starting post players. So they don't beat themselves, and they understand their own game and try to do the things that they can do and do that well.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a tough matchup for, our guys tomorrow. And, we're looking forward to it. We're looking forward to compete against them, and we have a lot of fun.
The one thing that my father instilled in me, I said, good basketball knows no divisions or limits. And, I didn't have the pedigree or the background of some of those players in the NBA. Maybe our Washington State team doesn't have the tradition of some of the schools that are in the NCAA tournament. But the thing we sell our guys and that I believed in as a player back then is if you do things the right way, if you play good basketball, it doesn't matter. You're going to have a chance to compete and advance and get to where you want to get to as a player, as a team, and that's real important.